Welcome to It Was Never You, where we talk about narcissism, complex PTSD, and recovery. Somebody had made a comment on one of the recent videos, and they said when a narcissist is called out for and told the truth, what they'll do is deny. That is an excellent point. Any of you that have been raised in this type of environment or have a spouse or whatever it may be in your life that has this type of nature about them, yes, they deny. And I just wanted to make a quick video on this. They will, whether they are covert, whether they are an overt, whether they are whatever, alien, whatever they may be, they will deny everything. They will twist it, they will turn it, they will say that never happened, they will gaslight you and say, that never happened that way, are you okay? Is there something wrong with you? There must be something wrong with your memory. Maybe you took something from somebody else's life and made it your own. These thoughts, you know, sometimes your friends around you are such a bad influence that you think that things that happened in their life actually happened in your life. That never happened. And they'll call other people and they'll say, did this happen? Did I do this? And the other person will say, no, you never did. No, you would never do that. They deny everything. It is gaslighting. They are denying your memories. They are denying your reality in order to make you go a little bit crazy every single time. And if I was listening to a story about a boy that was sitting with a psychologist and they were doing some kind of test on him. I forget the premise, but they were telling him, you were in the hospital and this happened to you. And he's like, no, that never happened to me. And over the course of like 2 or 3 weeks, they would tell this kid the same story over and over again. And at the end of the story, the kid had adopted their memories that they implanted in his, and he was adamant. They said, then at the end, they said, no, that never happened to you. And he goes, yes, it did happen to me. Yes, it did. So we as human beings are very susceptible to being manipulated. That is why it is a good idea if you're in this type of situation to keep a journal and to write things down or to record it, not for nefarious reasons or manipulative reasons, but just to have it for your own state of mind, because you will, your memory will be altered. And then it just becomes too much. And some of us will have huge memory gaps from our childhood, because this just becomes so frustrating that you just wanna, your brain just is like, you're gonna forget this, and you're not gonna, and then that leaves you with, well, what actually did happen in my life? And then you question those. When once you become healthy enough, the memories start to come back little by little, then you're questioning those memories, even though they are true and they can be corroborated by honest people in your life. You're going to have a hard time believing them because the narcissist is so good at denying and gaslighting. That's why gaslighting is one of the most effective manipulation techniques that you can ever do to somebody, altering their memories, telling them it never happened. And after a period of time, most people, that's a blanket statement, everybody. So I wouldn't even say most people. A lot of people will be susceptible over time to believing that their memories are incorrect. That person that said they will choose to deny in one of the comments, excellent point. And I hope that this did your comment some justice, because we have to stay grounded in reality and remember things how they actually were and not allow ourselves to be shaken.